Hello and how are you guys? Today I'm going to review this Classmate Octane Fountain pen. This is a very nice pen because I have written with this pen for a few years and then I stopped using this pen. So today I'll be reviewing this pen. So this pen I bought from Amazon. Today it came. So this is a this 40 rupees pen. And yeah, so let's open it. Before reviewing this pen, let me tell you, it is written here that the tip is iridium tip. Let's have a closer look on this pen. Yep. So if you can see, nothing is marked on this pen like Classmate or Octane. No, the nib is just a simple nib, and here it is written 14 number. So 14 number nib feed it is, and from inside it is made up of plastic, by the way. So let's plug the cartridges that we have got with this pen. And let's see how it works, how it writes, how smooth it is. So before checking it, I want to tell you that use this cartridge and insert it in this, and just before doing that, you'll have to wash this thing. I would suggest to wash the pen after you buy it, just wash it so that any particles inside this feed on nib will not interfere with the ink flow. Pen will last long, where you'll not have to clean it again and again. So before using that pen, you just make sure that you clean it with some water and then only you use. So before cleaning, we have 2 cups. In one we have water and one we don't have anything. So what we will do is just fill up the water in this like this. Hold less and just drop some few drops. So the water should pass through here till here and it should drop freely without applying any pressure. Don't apply any pressure. So if it is not coming, you make sure that you press a little, it will just water will come out and then it will drop. So you do it for 2 to 3 times. Make sure that there is no air bubble, otherwise it will block the flow of water and then you'll think that the flow water is not passing through. While buying a pen, you should make sure that the nib is okay. Nib in the sense, if you see here, just let me focus it. When you buy this, make sure that this nib tines are okay. You see the pen through this angle and you will come to know. And after that, you just make sure that the feed has a cut. You'll come to know in this video. I can't show you, but at the end of the video, I will show you how the cut should look like. So just clean it up for 2 to 3 times. Now you can see the water droplets are coming a little faster. Before it was very slow. So now anything like oil or something which was there while manufacturing will come out. And it will not interfere with your ink, because the water ink that we have here that we use in the fountain pens are made up of made up from water. Basically, those are the water-based ink. So if you mix oil and water, you know what are the consequences of that. So it will either restrict the flow, or otherwise it will allow the oil to flow, and that will not be good for your pen. So now you can see it is okay now, it is coming quickly. So now take one tissue paper and clean it up. make sure that you remove all the water, and then once you see something like this, yeah, so no water is there, so you can just apply some, you can blow from here to remove that water. You can either use something like this, like I have here in this pen, this cartridge converter, fix it inside, but it's little difficult if you are using Pierre Cardin or Bauer's this cartridge converter, but still you can just, if you apply some pressure it will go inside. But I will tell you, if you apply some pressure like this it will go inside, but I will tell you not to do so. Okay, so instead I will be using the same one that they have provided, that is the cartridge. Okay, so what you have to do is to see which side is the correct side. So I don't want you to puncture the this cartridge from this side. Okay, so this is the correct side, you can see a ball here. Okay, then you apply some pressure. Okay, now it is punctured, some water will spill out. That is because we have washed the pen. It will take some time, so you do one thing, you take a tissue paper and place it like this, and just from this side where you have your feet connect touching to the nib, that point you hold it like this, so you can see the ink is coming, and this time it is really quick. You try, if you want to try, you do one thing, you buy a pen and without washing it you just connect it like this, and you will see the difference why I'm saying. Yeah, now it is becoming a little thick. Yeah, so let's close this. It's a little tight. Okay, so let me change the angle or zoom it a little so that you will be able to see the video. So now this is a closer look to this pen. So maybe you'll not be able to see this, but see here, you can see a cut in the feed, this one. So that is nothing but that should be perfectly aligned with the cut in the feed. Now sometimes what happens is that feed contains either one cut or two cuts. So if there are two cuts, then it should pass from the middle. In this case, the cut in the nib is passing through the middle of these two cuts, so it's not visible in this video, but basically this pen has this nib of the feed of this pen has two cuts, so it is okay. So otherwise, if it is not, then you'll have to just use your thumb like this, and you just press the nib so that it perfectly aligns with the cut in the feed, and then otherwise it will create some nuisance in the flow. So let's write something. I would say the cost of this pen is just 40 rupees, but still the quality that you are getting here is very nice. Now the pen is little lighter because it is made up of plastic, so you can do one thing, you can add this cap. Let's do this drawing test. The paper is actually not good, that's why it is drying quickly. But let me just compare this result with the results of the other pen like this that I have here. Is this Bauer? This is a blue ink, Camlin blue ink. Okay, and so these are from Bauer. And if I do here, this is from Cam. This Octane, Classmate Octane. Now I have one more pen, which is this one, Pear Cardin. This is Camlin Red, Scarlet Red it is. So this, you can see this paper is not good, that's why I'm unable to show you. And this one more pen I have here is the Euro pen. I'll review this pen afterward, show you how this pen is. But if you want me to review this pen, please write in the comment section below. I'll keep some samples, how this pen writes and how it is, whether it is scratchy or not. But by the way, if you are writing with this, you can hear the scratchiness of this pen. It's not at all scratchy, I would say. It's so soft. I can't believe, because last time when I bought the pen, it was a little scratchy. But this is not. And maybe if you use some black color Camlin ink, so this will also go. By the way, the ink provided by them is very nice. Let me tell you guys that this is not at all scratchy. This is so soft. And if I talk about thickness of this, so I would compare this with the other pens that I have reviewed before, so that you can just check it. This was from Classmate. This is from Bao. Now we have Pear Cardin, Golden Eye. So you can see here, this is almost same. So this is medium nib, and feed is also a wet feed. Yeah, so nib is also wet nib, and similar to Pear Cardin, I would say. And Bauer is little bit softer than the if you want to see how fountain pens are, you can buy this pen. The ink that I have used here, this one was what we got from Classmate, so that I have shown. This ink was this one. Just let me just show you first. This is summer, that's why this is clogging, by the way. And if you are using fountain pens, make sure that you cap it after using. If you are just using it for if you are using that and then you are not capping that for even 5 seconds, then that will not be good for your nib. What will happen is the water in the ink will evaporate, and that will settle in the feed, and that will clog your feed, and you'll have to clean it again and again. So in that case, you make sure that you cap the pen, and make sure that you clean the pen as well, so that all the dirts will be cleared. And then this was Camlin Blue, Royal Blue, and this is Camlin Red. I will review this red ink because I liked it too much, so that's why I will make one review on that also. So please like the video if you like it, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.